Welcome to our service of silence and sorrow on this Good Friday. We are grateful that each one of you has taken the time to gather here today. In our liturgy, we will be sharing times of silence in 3-minute intervals to symbolize the 3 hours that Jesus suffered on the cross before his death. During our times of silence, do not worry about controlling your thoughts or blocking out the sounds around you. In a world filled with so much noise, silence can sometimes be uncomfortable and startling, but it can also be healing and revelatory. If the time feels long, hear that as a prompting from God to open yourself even more. Today, in this silence, we meet God in new ways. In this space, you are invited to hold your body and soul in whatever ways you are most comfortable. Listen to your breath, inhale and exhale, and be open to how the Spirit will move your soul. We will be prompted into silence with the ringing of a bell, and we will be invited back by a voice singing the first verse of "Were You There?" Let us now fully enter this space of sorrow and silence, focused on the question, what sorrows, mine or the world's, do I bring into this space? As we enter the final moments of the life of Christ, we seek not to rush to the resurrection, but to sit at the foot of the cross, a place where none of us wants to be, but a space many of us know all too well. So here we are, gathered together in the discomfort and disruption, in the grief and the sorrow, and in the anger and the anguish. As we gather, we also know that the sorrows of the world are created and reinforced by individuals and communities, with action or inaction, with subtlety or subconsciousness, with intent or impunity. For all the ways that we have added to the sorrow of others and ourselves, we lament and confess. As we enter this time of silence, let us reflect on the question, how have I, or how have we, added to the sorrow around us, personally, communally, and globally? We are forgiven for even our worst thoughts and our worst deeds. We are forgiven not as humans forgive with limit, but as only God is able to forgive, with the Holy One's unimaginable limitlessness. For this, we are grateful. And all of God's people say, Amen.
Our scripture readings today come from Matthew 27, which tells of the last moments of the life of Jesus. After each reading, we will have a time of silence and reflection on the question, how is this sorrow known today? We will not be sharing, so the Spirit's words to you are yours and yours alone. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the governor's headquarters, and they gathered the whole cohort around them. They stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on his head. They put a reed in his right hand and knelt before him and mocked him, saying, Hail, King of the Jews! They spat on him and took the reed and struck him on the head. After mocking him, they stripped him of the robe and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him away to crucify him.
As they went out, they came upon a man from Cyrene named Simon. They compelled this man to carry Jesus' cross. And when they came to a place called Golgotha, which means place of a skull, they offered him wine to drink mixed with gall. But when he tasted it, he would not drink it. And when they had crucified him, they divided his clothes among themselves by casting lots. Then they sat down there and kept watch over him. Over his head, they put the charge against him, which read, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." Then two bandits were crucified with him, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by derided him, shaking their heads and saying, "You who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. If you are the Son of God, come down from the cross." In the same way, the chief priests also, along with the scribes and the elders, were mocking him, saying, "He saved others, he cannot save himself. He is the King of Israel, let him come down from the cross now, and we'll believe in him. He trusts God, let God deliver him now. For he did say, 'I am God's son.'" The bandits who were crucified with him also taunted him in the same way.
when you hear the voice calling us back from this third reading and the third moments of silence, we invite you to join in singing with that voice. From noon on, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. And about 3:00, Jesus cried with a loud voice, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani?" That is, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "This man is calling for Elijah." At once, one of them ran and got a sponge, filled it with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink. But the others said, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him." Then Jesus cried again with a loud voice and breathed his last. In response to the word this day, you are invited to bring the sorrows and sufferings of the world to the cross. These can be personal, communal, or global, for no matter the level of pain, God can hold it all. We will do this by placing stones at the foot of the cross. If you did not receive one when you entered this space, they can be found at the basket in the middle of the aisle, and you are invited to retrieve one before coming forward. As you come forward and leave your sorrow, you are invited to speak it aloud or simply hold it quietly to yourself. And if you prefer to remain in your seat, that's okay too. After everyone has had a chance to come forward, the bell will be rung one final time. At the end of this ring, the space will become dark, and we will all leave in silence. So let us now offer our sorrows to God. And as you make your way to the cross, let us join in singing the second verse of "Were You There?" We will sing it through three times.